Suppose you are a farmer, and then one day you are checking your banana crop field. You can't help but notice a stunted banana plant. And looking up it closely, its leaves turned yellow, curly, and bunchy. At first, you thought it's not that of a big deal, so you just leave it at the back of your mind. Maybe it's just because of the hot weather, and you believe it would just return back to normal. Other leaves are looking fine anyway. However, just after 2 weeks, all its other leaves and its adjacent seedlings follow. What a nightmare for every hardworking farmer in our country. Now, if you're interested to know how this occurs and what unique factors influence it, you're in the right place. Hang in there and join us as we'll take you to this journey and venture into the world of the banana bunchy top disease. Stage 1, the reception. The infection begins on the basis of its leaf petiole. Zooming in, we can see a bunch of these banana black aphids or Pentalonia nigronervosa. As you can see, these are the ideal locations for them to eat all they can while they transfer the banana bunchy top virus or BBTV that they carry. Stage 2. Leaves are not for leaving. BBTV has finally entered the system and it will then propagate itself on the petiole's phloem during the first 15 days upon its inoculation. As this progresses, accumulation of these viruses then causes appearance of the first symptoms of the disease, the presence of dark green streaks and dots on leaves which highly resembles a Morse code. Overall propagation of BBTV causes depletion of hormone IPase, thus starving the plant from the nutrients it's supposed to have. This nutrient starvation then leads to shorter, narrower leaves and bunch leaves. Stage 3. Seeking for greener pastures. After its successful initial propagation on the leaves, BBTV then travels to the banana's pseudostem or false stem. BBTV lessens production of hormones that are directly responsible for regulating the plant's height, the gibberellic acid or GAs, thus resulting to the final symptom of BBTD, stunted growth. Stage 4. Pseudostem bridge is not falling down. Using the pseudostem as a bridge, the virus spreads to other parts of the plant, specifically its succeeding leaf petioles. This explains why infected bananas have these curled top leaves, thus overall making a bunchy appearance. But wait, to better understand BBTD, let's now talk about the whys and list down those unique factors that may cause BBTD. Let's now dive in. Hormonal imbalance. As discussed, emergence of BBTD symptoms are signs of hormonal imbalance caused by BBTV. This is because the plant favors the production of abscisic acid or ABAs as its response to the infection instead of production of the essential hormones needed for plant development. Age of host plant. Essentially, bananas can be infected by BBTV at any stage of growth. However, according to literature, young banana seedlings are much more prone to have severe symptoms than the older ones. This may be due to the fact that younger ones still have not fully developed their innate immune system, meaning their cells still do not possess enough special receptor proteins that can recognize pathogens and fight them off. For older plants, they often only develop mild symptoms in the form of a few dark streaks on the tips of the flower bracts. In this case, the banana can still produce a relatively viable fruit, although it may appear to be quite distorted or twisted. Cultivar or genetic makeup of the banana species. Interestingly, initial genomic analysis done on Musa cultivars Gros Michel, which is more resistant to infection, and widely grown dwarf Cavendish, which showed severe symptoms, revealed striking differences in their genomes. Hence, only a lower viral load will be present in the plant, which in turn only induces a mild degree of disease symptoms. In summary, we have learned these things. First, transmission of BBTV is assisted by our insect vector banana aphids. Second, BBTV initially replicates at the phloem of the petioles, then uses the pseudostem as a bridge to infect other parts of the plant, specifically its succeeding leaf petioles. Third, symptoms of BBTD, such as leaves Morse code, stunted growth, and bunchy leaves, are all caused by the hormonal imbalance triggered by the BBTV. And lastly, other unique factors that may explain the spectrum of symptoms aside from hormonal imbalance are age of host plant and the genetic makeup of the plant cultivar. We hope you learned a lot from this video, and may we keep education going. Thank you for watching.